Hey, hey, it's old Big Sid here once again, doing another video, but it's not just another video, this is a royal video. That's correct, you heard Big Sid right, it is a royal video. As most of y'all know, if you watch any kind of news, CNN, MSNBC, Fox News, whatever it is, local news, all they talking about is this fucking wedding, right? And I mentioned in a video I did a couple days ago that, you know, I was tired of it. I was tired of hearing about the whole thing. But it finally started getting to me. You know, I'm like, well, look, you know, I seen on here where it was Prince William and Kate. They're getting married. It's, you know, it's big, big affair. And I wrote some of these things down that I had heard. It said Jay-Z was going to be there, Beyonce. Snoop Dogg actually dedicated a song called Wet to Prince William's bachelor party. But when somebody actually followed up and was asking his office about it, there was no comment. I don't know why that would be, but anyway. I just got tired of hearing about it, and I figured, you know, why in the hell not jump on the bandwagon with everybody else? They're selling fucking all kind of mementos, all kind of postcards and stamps and figurines and probably fucking bobbleheads and everything else. So I figured that, you know, I'm going to try to come up with something to capitalize on this royal wedding. So supposedly Jay-Z and Beyonce are supposed to sing. I really don't care for either one of them. So I'm going to get the music started and I'm going to play a few selections of what I would play as music for the wedding or reception or whatever. So this is Saturday Nights for Fight, Elton John, and a couple other choice selections. Anywho, I thought and thought and thought about what in the hell can I do to possibly make some money at this wedding, right? You know, they're going to be having the traditional, probably fish and chips and scones and bitter English beer, I'm sure. But I mean, you know, that's what it's expected, you know. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up with something that's unexpected, which I already came up with. And what my idea is, and I hope that y'all like this, I really do. I spent a whole lot of time thinking about it, and you know, I just hope it works out. You know, I think it will. You know, I really do. So here it is. I'm not gonna wait any longer. I'm gonna tell you what my plans are. My plans are to serve pizza at the royal wedding. Okay, I don't know if you can quite see this. This is let me put it up to the camera. This is decent pizza. Not going to mention the brand name, the giveaway trade secrets. I'm actually serving it on a economy paper towel, and I'm actually serving it on chinette. Right, no fucking foam plates here. Chinette, good shit. Right, but notice all the red pepper. All the red pepper. You see all the red pepper that's on there. So I'm just going to demonstrate what's going to happen. I like red pepper. Not so sure everybody across the pond likes hot pepper. So this is what's going to happen, right? You get a piece of this pizza. It doesn't matter if it's cold or warm. Pizza's pizza. Just take a big old fucking bite out of it. Good pizza. This happens to be beef, mushroom, and onion. Taste the sauce, cheese, onions, hot peppers. Take another bite. Now my mouth's starting to burn a little bit. And I eat hot shit all the time, so I'm used to it. But my mouth is hot, you know. So I'm serving this pizza. People are gonna eat the pizza, and they're like, "Damn, you know, this shit's about to burn my fucking mouth up, right?" So they're looking for something to drink, you know. And you eat pizza, it's like you don't want no fucking bitter beer to wash that shit down. You know, you need something that's palatable, something that goes down smooth, something that something leaves you with a good buzz, you know. Because you'd have to be buzzed to watch this fucking wedding. So anyway, part two of Big Sid's capitalization of the royal wedding. I plan on serving a custom beverage. Not just any beverage. You're not going to believe this. We're going to serve 40-ounce ye olde malt liquor. That is correct. You heard it here first. Big Sid's channel, 40-ounce ye olde malt liquor. And you're going to say, "Well, Sid, anybody can, you know, slap some shit on a damn 40 bottle or whatever." I'm like, no, I actually produce this shit. And in order to assure that you're getting a genuine Big Sid's ye olde malt liquor, 40 ounce of course,
what's up, fresh is out,
you will have to check and make sure that your label is attached to the bottle with duct tape. That's correct. Duct tape. The real duct tape, not the imitation shit. If you get a bottle of this shit and it's not attached, the label's not attached with real duct tape, then you have gotten a reproduction and you haven't got the genuine article. So keep an eye out for 40-ounce ye olde malt liquor. So I'm going to crack this sumbitch open. I can get it open. Got pizza grease on my hand. Probably should sell napkins too. There we go. Hell yeah. So you hit him with a 1-2 combo, right? They drink the beer, malt, and so it makes it cools their mouth off. Then they want some more of this pizza. So the heat starts building again. Go back right for the malt liquor. It's a win-win. I expect to make millions of dollars in this venture. Once the proceeds start coming in, I plan to spread the wealth. You know Kate and William gonna be dancing this shit. I ain't in that damn Jay-Z, man. Thank you. Hell yeah. So what y'all think? Y'all think it's a good idea? I do. I'm still flying. You know what I mean? This shit, look how good it's going down. Give you a man-sized thirst. Would be complete without Biggie. God rest his soul. One of the last real rappers, in my opinion. Enjoyed this shit. Fuck you. Yeah. I'll even drink the phone, motherfucker. Alright, I'm gonna cut this before it hit 15 minutes. It's old Big Sid. Hope to see y'all soon. Watch my shit. BDU, motherfuckers. Bye.